So it's official now that Elance is being winded down. This is a Facebook post from Elance on its Facebook page saying that today we announced plans to wind down the Elance platform and offer tools to help you move your work history and reputation to Upwork over the next few months. There's more information which they've put up. Now, my point would be that if you look at reactions, they've been so strongly negative, you know. It could have been one, it would be one thing if it was, say, mildly negative or apprehensive, but then they've all been so negative. If you know, so many of these responses, you can take a look at them. People are so concerned, and perhaps to quite an extent, these concerns are legitimate. You know, the quality of jobs on Upwork, the sheer competition which is likely to be there given the number of freelancers, because once you have this kind of consolidation, Odesk had so many freelancers, Elance had so many. Now, when you have all of them together on one platform called Upwork, the number of freelancers would definitely quadruple. And at the same time, you know, when there's a general sense of dissatisfaction, many of them will probably, you know, go their way. That's what I foresee. So I'm just scrolling down, and you can continue to see so many. Like, again, there's one more here. Very, very bad idea. Upwork is nowhere near to Elance, and projects on Upwork are very bad. You know, these kind of it's a bad idea. Elance is better than Upwork. Upwork will not survive. There are already so many bugs and flaws. I'm not loving this. Elance is stable, clean, and easy to use. Upwork is still not fully created. And so many such reactions. Upwork should be moved to Elance, not Elance to Upwork. Elance is a better place. I'm totally disappointed with the kind of moves by Elance these days. I want to stay on Elance. If you every single reaction, honestly, I preferred working on Elance than Upwork. Upwork platform is slow and not user-friendly. Elance, do we have to use Upwork or can we just stick to our Elance accounts? This is really a bad, bad, bad idea. Who made this decision? You know, so you go on and every single reaction that you see, would you please that and close the Elance permanently? Combining these two web will mean disaster in the freelancers world. Not happy about this. Been with Elance for 10 years. I'm still looking over Upwork. Hi guys, today I've received this email for you and okay, this is an outrage. I made an Upwork account a year ago. All good, but Elance is a way better name. I can't describe in words how sad it is. So you know, you get a good feel of the general sentiments of the community, which is so strongly inclined towards negative. You know, if they were, say, partially positive and negative, one could understand, but they seem to be almost completely negative. And now I'll just hop on to the water cooler section on Elance so that you know you get some more value add from this video in terms of say dates. What Elance has done is they've sent out an email where the whole winding down process is being looked into, and specifically in terms of say steps, stages, or dates. So here is something which I think you'll find very useful. In early August, new customers will no longer be able to register for Elance. So, which means we are just about a month away from new customers not being able to register on Elance. Starting in September, we'll begin to limit the ability to post new jobs on Elance. Through early 2016, you can continue your current projects on Elance. However, we encourage you to begin all new contracts on Upwork and move existing contracts to Upwork when possible. Through mid-2016, you will still be able to access your messages, contacts, and files on Elance. So you have a rough idea of the timeline which follows from now on. Now I'm recording this towards the beginning or mid of July. So we are looking at about a month from now when new customers will no longer be able to register. When they say new customers, I wonder whether they mean new freelancers, new clients, or both. And a month from then, they limit the ability to post new jobs. And then I don't understand that they are giving some time frame. Maybe they should have winded down soon enough, but still, through early 2016. So let's say maybe January, February 2016, you can continue your current projects However, we encourage you to begin all new contracts. So that means any new jobs which you commence with, maybe you can do that on Upwork. That's what Elance is saying. Through mid-2016, you will still be able to access your messages, contacts and files. So which means, let's say, pretty much a year from now, you know, June odd 2016, June, July, should be able to still access your messages, contacts. Now, whether one will be able to continue working on Elance or not, that's something I think probably by then that'll probably not be able to, you won't be able to do. Upwork has already proven to be a rewarding marketplace for freelancers. That's what the email, you know, continues to say. But then this is something which probably a lot of others will find debatable, because most people seem to contend that when it comes to the marketplace, it has not been rewarding. And Odesk, as when it was as Odesk, it was probably exemplified by too many freelancers and too many people vying for the projects there, with the extent that prices practically, you know, spiral downwards to just no limit at all. You know, some really ridiculous prices. So that's a major concern. And to quite an extent, personally, if you ask me, I think a lot of these concerns are quite legitimate. What I saw on Odesk when it was as, you know, functioning as Odesk, lot of projects, but at the same time, lot of freelancers and people quoting absolutely ridiculous prices. And in comparison, what I found on Elance was that at least there were projects with reasonable prices. You know, that's the difference. Okay, let me go on with resulting in higher freelancer earnings than on Elance. Let's see about that. You know, that seems to be the biggest issue of contention. We're also working to deliver innovations to boost your productivity. Mobile apps are now available for iOS and Android, and a new messaging tool. Thank you for your business on Elance. We appreciate your patience during this transition and look forward to welcoming you to the Upwork community. You can read more about this announcement on our blog. Best regards, Stephen Castriel, CEO, Upwork. Now, let's see, you know, I think Upwork has continuously painted a picture where things will be bright and things will be good. Let's see. One thing, yes, I personally feel is that change is often difficult, and the transition stage when any change happens is particularly painful, with speculation marring the whole process. You know, people are very scared that, oh, what's going to happen, things will not work out, and generally there's a negative mindset. Eventually, when things do fall into place and things do seem to be fine, then there's not so many, you know, concerns. And then people reflect back, oh, I was so concerned about this, I was so worried, but probably my concerns were not unfounded. So let's see. I think it's good to be optimistic, but so far what I've seen of Odesk and of Upwork, the way it is now, I think a lot of the concerns are legitimate. Let's see what the future holds in store. Cheers.